What's going on, everybody? In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix duck and how you're going to want to fix it from now on. Stay tuned and let's get cooking. Okay, guys, for this recipe, what you're going to be needing is some thick cut bacon, an apple, I prefer Granny Smith, some sugar, some butter, some cinnamon, and of course, duck meat. Duck breasts filleted out. This happens to be from two mallards that I shot yesterday. They've been soaked in water overnight and had the blood drained out of them. So let's dive into this, and I'm gonna show you how you're going to cook duck for the rest of your life. What I like to start out doing first is going ahead and cutting up this apple. I'm just gonna wanna cut this apple up into about half to a quarter inch slices. Cut out the tough part of that apple. Our next step is we're going to take all of this duck meat out. And we're going to go ahead and trim all of the fat off of it. Be sure you check these pieces of meat for pellets. We're going to be cooking these whole, and you don't want to bite down and grab a pellet on one of those juicy, delicious bites that we're going to be taking here in a few moments. And we're just going to go ahead and stick it back in the bowl. And everything is prepped and ready to be cooked. So let's move on over to the stove, and I'll show you where I go to from here. Over here at the stove, we're going to go ahead and preheat our big skillet that we're going to be frying our duck in. You will need two skillets for this. Here, we're going to go ahead and start preheating, and then we're just going to slice open the duck. Excuse me, we're going to slice open the bacon. We're going to go ahead and peel a couple pieces out and get them ready to start frying up. So let's get this fried up. While we're waiting on our bacon and our skillet to heat up, we're going to go ahead and we're going to preheat the other side of the stove here, and we're just going to melt about 2 tablespoons of butter. Okay, now if you'll notice, we've got some bubbles that are starting to form in this, like it's almost like it's boiling. So what we're gonna do is we're going to take these apple slices and lay these apple slices down in the butter. And what we're doing is we're actually caramelizing this apple. Once we have a good even coating on all of the apple slices, still got a little bit of butter left in there, that's okay. We're going to take, don't mean to bump the camera, I'm going to take some sugar, and sprinkle a little sugar over it. And once again, we're just kind of coating it up, and it's going to start making a glaze on these apples. And then after we've added the sugar, we're just going to go through, throw a little bit of cinnamon on them, give them a little bit of a cinnamon taste, mix that around, and we're just going to let those sit in that heat for a few moments and stir, not let them burn. Okay, so now we've got our bacon grease that is done. I'm gonna go ahead and season this duck breast with a little bit of Mrs. Dash. And Mrs. Dash chicken, by the way. We're gonna stick this duck meat in there. We're gonna stick it in for about 4.5 minutes per side. The goal is medium to medium rare. A little bit more medium than rare. But this is where people go wrong. People overcook their duck, and it makes it very tough, and it's almost like eating an old piece of boot leather or something. Let's go ahead and cut this just to see the consistency is looking like. That piece is about perfect. Go ahead and get a better grip on it so I don't drop it. But let's see here. About right. So what we're going to do is pull this meat off of the fire and let it rest for a few moments. These dudes are done, nice, soft, and caramelized. We're just about ready to do some plating. Our meat has rested for a moment. The way that I like to do this is start out by making a small bed of this bacon. bit of these apple slices down. Kind of arrange them so. And then we'll take our duck. Then what we want to do is try to scrape up just a little bit of this caramelized butter, a little bit of that sauce, and just drizzle it over that duck. This is so good, if you put it on your head, your tongue would beat your brains out to try to get to it.
But guys, I hope you've enjoyed this quick episode and hope you were able to try this recipe out, enjoy it the way that I have. And I'm so thankful for this because now, not only can I enjoy the process of the harvest, but I can also enjoy eating the harvest. Thanks for watching this episode of Jared Davis Outdoors. I hope this has helped you a ton. And look forward to seeing the comment section below to those of you who have tried it. So be sure and comment, like, and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching this episode of Jared Davis Outdoors. We'll see you next time.